This is a similar ECG with so many arrows being pointed to so many things. Actually, you need to determine what are the things are going on here. So obviously seen are the huge R waves, like when you see huge R waves going everywhere and marking downwards in the few anterior leads and marking upwards in the few lateral leads. Obviously it means that the electrical conduction or the muscle thickness of the heart is very huge, and most probably the deep negativity confirms that this is the ventricular, left ventricle, which is hugely thickened. So coming to the lead 2, we will go for the P waves. P waves appear slightly enlarged, but not to that much to explain that the P arterial enlargement is there. There is slight prolongation of the P waves in the lead 2. And coming to the axis to the first, the lead 1 is the most positive and also lead AVL. So most probably going towards left axis deviation. And coming to the STT, the ST segment and T wave inversion can be seen in the lead 1 and AVL, suggestive of lateral strain or ischemia. And then AVRS, everything is inverted and there is deep S, so suggestive of like normal or conduction. There is no conduction abnormalities or the major CAD kind of thing. And then in V1 to the suspicion, it confirms that there is a deep P wave inversions in the lead V1 and lead V2, confirming that there is an LA enlargement, secondary to most probably the LV hypertrophy. That's what we can feel. Even LV enlargement can be there because these amplitudes of huge cavity sizes may be seen in LV enlargement. So that's LV hypertrophy is what, like, you can add up the things like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this is huge. It's most probably like 45 or 55 or 60. So usually more than 30, 35 is considered as LVH at any leads RS measurement. This is what is also pointed here, that is the repolarization, dissociation. So these dissociation, as I always suggest, it's either ischemia, strain, Bunda branch abnormalities should be suspected of. So here is the strain and the ischemia. Strain always causes ischemia during the resting intervals. So here what we can feel, that there is an LA enlargement, there is an LV hypertrophy. To added upon that, I feel that there is a prominent STT waves are there. So added upon that, there will be LV enlargement also. So LV enlargement with this much of negativity in right side, showing that there is no right axis deviation, there is no right ventricular enlargement or hypertrophy or even pulmonary hypertension. So just should suggest like the valvular regurgitation lesions kind of thing. Okay.